To discuss about array, and in previous lecture we learned about array and their types. Basically there are two types of array, single dimensional and double dimensional. And if you are talking about array, then we use array for initializing multiple values in a single variable. So basically class, now today we are going to discuss some more things about array. And in class 9, in the beginning of class 9, we learn how to give input in a variable. Like normally what we do is write a equal to 10, b equal to 20, and then sum equal to a plus b, and then we see in a variable c there is a sum of a and b. So there is a different way of initializing values, like input stream reader, scanner class, BlueJS system, and argument system. There are multiple ways of initializing or giving input in a variable, but we must continue with scanner class. Now in this class also we are going to discuss about assignment statement, BlueJS system, input stream reader class and scanner class. But we will continue with scanner class. So in our previous lecture we learned how to create array type variables, because if I am writing int a, then it is a integer type variable. A is a integer type variable. If I am writing char c, then c is a character type variable. Now suppose I want to create a as an array type integer variable. Well, it is only integer variable and I just want to create array type integer variable. So I just write here int a square bracket equal to new int in block. Okay, I'm writing here. So what we see, a is a array type integer variable. Okay, float f is equal to new float 5. Now f is a array type decimal value, decimal value. So if you want to create character variable, then we have need to write char c, new char and number blocks. For string, string s equal to new string and number of blocks. So we all know how to create variable, array type variable in a different data type. But now class, we are going to discuss about initializing values in a variable in different way, because basically there are four different ways for giving input in a array variable. Okay, if you have an array variable a, so and the number of blocks are 5 there, so you can store 5 values in a A type variable. But there are different way of initializing or giving input in a variable. Okay, so the first is assignment, second is BlueJS system, third is input stream reader class, and the fourth one is scanner class. So now we are going to discuss about assignment statement, and then we will discuss about these three statements. So now if we are talking about assignment statement, okay, so if we are using assignment statement for input variable in array type variable, so we have a four type of values. Okay, for integer value, for floating value, for character value, for string value. So what we see, if we are using assignment statement, if we are using this statement for input values in a variable, then we have four type of values: integer, decimal, character and string. So now we are going to discuss about assignment statement for integer value, and then we will discuss about assignment statement for floating value. And there are four types of values are there. So one by one we will learn all type of values. So now first is assignment statement for integer value. What is assignment statement for integer value? Assignment statement for integer value. So if we are taking an example of this one, so I am writing an example. A bracket open close equal to curly bracket and then values, okay, and then this will be closed. This is an example, but we will confirm or clear this example with the help of program. So now we are going to create a program where we input values and then print on our console screen. So see class, we always start our program through public class sample and then public static void main string args, okay, and then int a new int 5. So now we all know int a equal to 5. So we have a variable a and where we can store 5 values, okay. So now a equals to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, okay. So one more thing class, we do not have need to write this one. If I am initializing value at this time, so I can write in this way. Int a, because we are using assignment statement, so int a bracket open close equals to, okay. So now what we see, the variable a is a array type integer variable. And now what we do, we just initialize input value 10, 20, 30, 40, okay. And then semicolon. Now after this, I'm going to print these values on our output screen, or we can say that on our console screen. So I'm just writing for int I equal to 0, I is less than or equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, and then I plus plus. Now after this, system dot out dot print ln and then value means a of I, okay, and then it will be close and then this one and then this one. So this is our basic way for creating values and then we print, because first we create variable, okay, array type variable. And then we run loop and then we print the values. Okay class, so now let's see how we complete these processes. Now here we are going to done our process and here we will continue with our output. Okay, so see class, a of 10, 20, 30 and 40. So it means there is an array A, variable A, and here we can store 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay? Four values are there. And now if you are talking about their indexing, their subscript, their address, then we all will always start from 0 and then 1 and then 2 and then 3.
So now, in first loop, when I equal to 0, then 0 is less than or equal to 3, condition is true. Now if condition is true, then it comes here and print A of I. So now it print A of I. So what is the value of I? It is 0. So it print A of 0. So now what is the value of A of 0? A of 0 is 10. So the output is 10. Okay class? Now after printing the value, it comes here and then I plus plus. So in second loop, I equal to 1, and then A of I means A of 1, and now we will need to print A of 1 value. So A of 1 is 20, so our output is 20. And then third loop, I equal to 2, A of I, so we have need to print A of 2, and A of 2 is 30, so it print 30. Okay, and then fourth number of loop, I equal to 3, and then A of I, which is equal to A of 3, and then A of 3 means 40, so it print 40. And in fifth number of loop, I is 4, so A of I means A of 4. But the problem is that when I equal to 4, because of increment symbol, then it comes here and check 4 is less than or equal to 3. So the condition is false. So if the condition is false here, then it terminates this loop. And in this program, because there is no any type of other task which we have need to complete or which program we have need to complete, so after terminating with this loop, the program will terminate and our output is 10, 20, 30 and 40. And the loop runs fourth number of time, and when loop runs fifth number of time, then the value of I is 4. In last, the value of I is 4. Then this is a basic way or basic process for completing array type of program. Now we are going to done one more program with integer. So now see class, in this program we are going to create a program where we give initialize values in an array variable, and then what we do, we just add all the numbers. So see how we done this. Public class sample sum. Public static void main string args, and then int a equals to 10, 20, 30, 40. Int sum equal to 0. For int, before run this line, I'm going to write it. System dot out dot print ln, and now sum of array values. Okay, and then for int I equal to 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, I is less than or equal to 3. If you want, then you can also write here I is less than 4, and then I plus plus. Okay, and then sum equal to sum plus A of I, and then system dot out dot print ln, and then we print the value which is sum. Okay, and now this will be closed. This will be closed. So see class, what we do in this program? In this program, we just input four values in array type variable A, and then with this process, we add all the values. Okay, so see how we done this process. When program start, then there is a variable A which is an array type variable. So there is a 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay, and then there is the one another variable sum. So sum equal to 0. And then SOPLN, sum of array. So I'm just writing output is here. Okay. So output is sum of array value. So it print here sum of array value. Okay. Because of this statement, and then it comes here where I equal to 0. Okay. So there is a I which is also equal to 0, and then 0 is less than 4. So C class, when first loop run, then I equal to 0 and 0 is less than 4, then condition is true, and when condition is true, then it comes here, and then sum equal to sum plus A of I. So the value of sum is 0, and A of I means A of 0. So we all know 0, 1, 2, 3. So A of 0 means 10. So it is equal to 10. Okay? And then in second loop, I equal to 1. And then sum equal to, see class, the formula is sum plus A of I. So sum means 10 plus A of I means A of 1. And A of 1 means 10 plus 20, which is equal to 30. Okay, so in second number of time, it is 30. Okay, 10 plus 20, which is equal to 30. And then in third loop, I equal to 2, sum equal to, again, sum plus A of I. So the value of sum is 30. So 30 plus A of I. So A of 2 means 30. It is equal to 60. In fourth number of loop, I equal to 3 and sum equal to, we all know how I equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, because all time it incremented by one number. So in first loop it is 0, second loop incremented by 1, then it is 1. In next loop incremented by 1, it is 2, and then 3. So when I equal to 3, then sum equal to sum plus A of I. So sum means 60 and A of I means A of 3, which is 40, and then it is 100. So in last, the value of I is 100. Okay, and in fifth number of loop, I equal to 4. So it comes here and 4 is less than 4. Condition is false. So if the condition is false, then it terminates this loop and comes here and print the value of sum, which is 100. And just because of ln, it changed the line. And 100, so 40 plus 30 is 70, plus 20 90, and plus 10 100. So in last, you print 30 and 100, and then terminate this loop. So now class, in our next lecture, we'll learn about assignment statement for character value, for string value, and for